What's My Line? Brought to you by Polygrip, the modern cream denture adhesive that grips evenly, grips comfortably, grips firmly all day long. And now let's all play What's My Line? From New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, who just flew in from London just in time to be with us tonight, and here she is, Miss Phyllis Newman.
My great pleasure tonight to introduce a very talented man who just finished writing, directing, and appearing in a movie which will open in the middle of May in New York, Lady L, Mr. Peter Ustinov.
And now, dressed in a ravishing pink tennis net, the foot faultless Arlene Francis.
And now an extraordinary gentleman who runs the gamut from punster to publisher and does both exceedingly well, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I've always told you what a fraud our panel moderator is. I read in the paper this morning, picking up the paper idly, a recipe, John Daly's recipe for how to make swordfish. Now, he's never been nearer a kitchen than when he called out to his wife for a piece of sweetbox. And here he is giving recipes for how to make swordfish. And here is the swordfish expert himself, John Charles Daly.
What Bennett neglected to say was I never made any claims to being able to cook. I just said, know what I'd like to eat. Swordfish I like to eat very much. Besides, speaking of frauds, I'm glad you're going back. Bennett's going back to school this week, and nobody needs it more than he does. He's going to Fredonia to New York State University. And then you're going to Manhattan, Kansas, to Kansas State and Washburn University.
That's right.
And then you're going to run for Houston and Pittsburgh.
That's right.
A gentleman doesn't get enough activity. Miss Newman and Mr. Ustinov, how nice to see you here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Did we do the right thing?
I think so.
You nervous?
No.
No, nothing to be nervous about. We've got some very interesting occupations, but I'm sure they'll give none of you any difficulty. So just relax and enjoy yourselves for the next half hour. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program, but right now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
Peter Tofts, right, sir? Mr. Tofts, where are you from?
I come from London, England.
From London, England?
That's right.
Oh, it's nice to have you here. May I present our panel, Mr. Tofts?
Good evening.
And now, if you'll join me over here, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Tofts is salaried and deals in a service. And I think we should begin things with Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Mr. Tofts, you do your service... Do you do your service in London? Do you perform your service in London?
Yes.
When you perform your service, do people watch you do this?
Yes.
When you do what you do, could it be called entertaining?
Yes.
Oh.
Let me just interject something here. We agree that Mr. Tofts can perform his service in London. This does not exclude other localities. Two, we agree that people watch him, but this does not necessarily mean anything more than that there are other people present, and that since what he does would be interesting, they would watch.
Where did I go wrong?
You didn't. No, you didn't. I just didn't want you to be misled by too broad an answer, that's all.
I see. But you said that it is, you would consider it entertaining.
Yes.
Yes. Now, do people pay to see you do what you do?
Yes.
When you do what you do, Would I like what you did better if I were younger than what I am?
No.
No, I don't think so.
Right.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Topps, are you left-handed?
Yes.
You noticed the training. You use both hands on your job?
Yes.
But you use your left hand rather than your right hand?
No.
Nope. That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
What were you driving at?
I wasn't driving at all. I was a passenger.
Are there any people doing what you're doing when you're doing it?
I don't understand that question.
Are there other people doing whatever you do when you are doing what you do? Rather than doing it solo.
I'm still baffled. I'm sorry.
Instead of doing what you do solo, are other people doing it at the same time?
No.
You're all alone.
You see, this is the trouble. This is why this gives us a little burden. The exact same thing, the answer would be no. But if the intent of your question was to ask if others were working in the same area and to achieve perhaps the same or a similar end, the answer would be yes.
That's what I meant.
That's what you had.
What I had in mind.
Then the answer is yes.
Is what you do something that might be considered some kind of game or sport?
No,
I don't think so. Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tufts, when you are performing this service, are you wearing something other than what you're wearing on this panel show this evening?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Newman.
When you do what you do, is there any music involved?
Yes.
When you do what you do, do you do the music? Do you have anything to do with the music?
Five down and five to go, Mr. Ustinov.
When you do what you do... I presume you are not conscious of the music.
Yes, I'm conscious of the music.
But what I mean by conscious is, do you have any link with the music?
Yes.
Do you have to keep in time?
Yes. Sorry, no matter how you rephrase it, the old no is coming right down the road. That's six down.
You've never learned English here. It was a perfectly good phrase.
I tell you, sir, what can I tell you?
Equivocal, like all good English phrases.
Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work, Mr. Tofts, in either a club or a hotel room or a theater?
I could work in any one of those places.
Is the audience ever used with you when you are performing? Are they part of what you do, the people that are watching you?
You mean in the sense of audience participation so that they would be critical and necessary to the completion of the service which he wants to deliver?
No is my answer, right, John?
That's right. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tofts, do you ever warble a song or play some instrument that renders that song?
No, sir. Nope. I'm pretty unmusical.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Newman.
Now, we have to get back to this. You're doing what you're doing. Somewhere else, there's music playing. Or there, music is playing. Is that right so far?
Yes.
Are you speaking? Do you say anything?
No.
That's nine down and one to go, Mr. Ustinov.
And you say you're dressed as you are now. Is that? Did I understand that correctly?
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. You are there regularly and not in an emergency.
Right.
There regularly.
Do people pay to see you?
Not to see me, no.
Not to see him, but with Mr. Toff's permission, we'll let the question go on the broader basis that people do pay to see what is the end result of the service.
You are not in sight from the audience point of view. You are behind the stage or arena.
That's right.
You work some kind of technical instrument or crew.
Yes.
John,
are you in charge of people or... just a moment. Maybe this will refresh your memory. Are you to do with the stage management side of anything?
No.
Not specifically, but you came very close, Peter, and you're to be congratulated because 10 down and no more to go. Mr. Tofts makes Superman fly in the Broadway musical. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's Superman.
Very good.
I'm delighted to see that the British aircraft industry is not dead.
Yes, there's one plane they don't have to buy from America.
Yes.
Now, that'd be very interesting, actually. Mr. Tufts climbs on a 14-foot ladder, and there's a torso harness around the flyer, I guess you'd call it. And it's counterweighted, and when it's time for him to take off, he just goes right down, jumps off the ladder, and down he goes, and then two other men work about it, I guess you call the guys, and they handle this flight and or this flight pattern. So
it's the same way that Mary Martin does.
That's right. It's similar to Mary Martin.
You work
but
with
we've
her
slightly
too?
No, I've not worked with Mary Martin, but I did the old-fashioned Peter Pan in England as a penance, which we call penance time in England, flying Peter Pan in England. With
well, it's different upwards. Because Mary Martin and he have different corridors. There have been so many collisions lately.
Well, Mr. Thompson, at least we stuck the panel, and thanks for coming to see us. Nice to see you. We'll have another contestant for you in just a moment after this word. And now to meet our next challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Frank M. Botley, right, sir?
Botley, where are you from, sir?
Hazel, Pennsylvania.
Hazel?
Hazleton,
Pennsylvania.
Yes, sir.
Well, you have some friends in the house. Nice to have you with us. May I present the panel? And now, Mr. Botley, if you'll join me over here, sir, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. As I told you, panel, a nice, relaxed, easygoing evening we're going to have tonight. We can tell you that Mr. Botley is self-employed and deals in a product. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Botley, is it a useful product?
Yes.
Is it a product that I might possibly own?
Yes.
Might a man own it, too?
Ma'am? Yes.
If either one of us had this product, might we keep it in the house?
Yes.
Would it be in any, if we had a two-story house, would it be on the lower floor?
Yes.
Would I be able to hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Would I want to?
Want to? Yes.
Would I ever have it in the kitchen?
Yes.
Is it consumable?
Yes.
Would I put it in my mouth?
Yes.
Would it be all right if I swallowed it?
Yes.
Is it something other than something I might keep in the refrigerator?
Yes.
Is it something other than food?
Well, it's food.
Is it something it is. I would not have in my diet? Does that make it easier? No.
Well, you wouldn't specifically... yes, you would not specifically have it in your diet. It is consumed. It is certainly a
yes.
food. It is related to the whole process of eating and so forth.
Would I be liable to put it on something rather than have it all by itself?
Well, you could put it on something.
Would it make me happy?
Oh, yes.
Yes?
Yeah?
Is it liquid rather than solid?
No.
Something solid could make me happy, too.
Yeah, what? That's $1.09 to go, Bennett.
Mr. Botley, I know that Hazleton's sort of a center of the... coal industry. May I eliminate any product, whatever, that has to do with the coal industry?
Yes.
I ate it.
Well, you coal can be made into all kinds of candy and stuff. Yeah. Cold drinks. You've heard of cold drinks, haven't you? Mr. Bartley, this is definitely something to eat. You're not taking us down the garden path.
We have said that it's a part of the food family, yes.
Might it be considered a spice or condiment?
Yes.
Has it got a sharp, tangy taste?
Yes.
Would it ever be used with frankfurters?
Could be.
Is it brownish in color?
No.
No.
It's not mustard.
No, it's 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Newman.
Mr. Botley, if I left this out in the kitchen, would it smell?
Well.
Yeah, you know it was around. It was around. Yeah, under certain circumstances.
Okay, now it has a sharper odor than most normal foods have. A stronger odor.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
If I had a knife, could I cut it?
Yes.
Is it in any way a dairy product?
No. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Bartley, I don't want to seem greedy, but is there room for 2 at once of these things in my mouth?
Yeah, there'd be room.
Well, then I presume that there's room for many more. A few more.
Few more?
They are usually consumed in the plural, are they? Would one hardly taste?
No, they're not usually consumed in the plural. 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Francis.
Does whatever this is grow in the ground?
Yes.
Is it used very often in Italian cooking?
Well, yes.
Is it in the garlic family?
Yes.
Is it indeed garlic?
Yes.
Mr. Botley is a retired government employee who has found a new occupation. He grows garlic. And this is his second year, and he's having a great time. He grows garlic called elephant garlic. They're 8 times larger than the standard size garlic, which is a happy thought. Right? That's elephant right. garlic, That's 8 right. times larger, and he's got a whole new life, and he's having a grand time.
I bet his neighbors have a whole new life, too.
We had so much fun today. We'll throw all those cards over, and thank you very much, Mr. Buffy. Nice to have you with us. Tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message. And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the panel is always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? This time, a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin things with Bennett, sir.
Well, unless those lecherous, lascivious whistles have led me astray, this is a very pretty girl. Are you?
Yes, indeed. Miss Newman.
Are you in a movie that's currently in New York?
Well, perhaps I would hope so.
Mr. Ustinov?
But you don't live in New York.
No, not for my nose, no.
What?
No.
Yes, does not live in New York. Miss Francis?
Are you something other than American?
Well, in my mind.
What? But not really. Mr. Cerf.
She is American. Are you quite a young star?
Well, that is younger than 9 out of 16.
Younger than 30, let's say.
Yeah.
What, younger than 30 is
yes.
what I meant.
Miss Newman?
Is your hair dark?
Yes.
Mr. Ustinov?
Your hair is not light.
No.
Are you here on a visit?
Are you here for what?
And have you got your visa?
You mean to come to New York, Peter?
Have I answered? Oh, I haven't answered the question yet. I haven't.
No.
Are you going back somewhere soon?
Well, are you going back somewhere soon?
Shortly, in probability, yes.
Miss Francis?
Did you recently visit Harvard University?
Well, you found me out.
Yes? Yes, you did?
Yeah.
Yes. Is it Natalie Wood?
Natalie Wood.
Remarkable young lady, and also very lucky, you know, with that wonderful accent. You'd never know she was born in San Francisco. California girl.
She's the best sport in Hollywood.
And the best sport in Hollywood.
She came to the Harvard boys who were kidding her, and she appeared there and won the hearts of the entire Harvard University.
Oh.
Yeah. Actually, Bennett can speak with validity here. He's still trying to get through. What? Now, but you are a San Franciscan, aren't you?
Yes, I was born in San Francisco.
Uh-huh. And I love the country up there in Napa. This year I found a desert this week, the Borrego Springs. Have you ever been down there? It's quiet and peaceful, and beautiful, beautiful.
Is it near Santa Rosa?
No, actually, it's northeast of San Diego.
It's
up in the desert.
Yeah.
It's very quiet. Yeah, great. And there's somebody from San Diego here, too. The picture is going to open. The property is condemned. That's the latest picture.
This property is condemned. Yes.
This property. That's going to be here in June.
It will be here soon, yeah.
Yeah, it'll be in June.
Sidney Pollack directly.
There's one going now inside Daisy Clover.
Inside
yes,
Daisy Clover.
But it's not playing on Broadway, I don't think.
No, but they didn't ask you that. I thought we might trip them with
that.
Because they didn't ask specifically. The question was phrased on the basis, is it playing around in New York?
Yes.
So we had to say yes to that. Hope to trip them on the Broadway, perhaps. Are you going back to San Francisco from here, or are you going back to Los Angeles?
No, to Los Angeles.
I
live in Los Angeles.
Live in Los Angeles. Yes. Ava, forgive you for that in San Francisco? Do you think?
Well, I visit there a lot. My sister lives there.
Oh, good. As long as some of the family's still there, I guess you can get away with it.
Yes.
Well, thanks very much for coming in to see us tonight, and have a good trip back home.
Thank you very much.
Lots of luck with the next... Peter, do you really think we have to have a visa to come to New York from Los Angeles? You think we need a visa to come to New York from Los Angeles?
Well, I didn't know that she came from Los Angeles.
You didn't? Oh.
I thought it was Stockholm.
Stockholm. Well, I've got to admit, panel, I told you it was going to be an easy evening. It was a little bit tough, but you've done very well. We'll all be back after this word. Good night, Phyllis.
Good night. And good night, Peter.
Yes. Pass it along. Good night.
Good night, Peter. You're a joy. Good night, Bennett.
John, now that you've told us so much about swordfish, would you like to tell us what's the matter with the New York Yankees?
All I said is I can't cook, and I don't know what's wrong with the New York Yankees right now. But thanks to all of you for coming to join us on What's My Line.
CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. This is Johnny Olson speaking.
In the ground?
Yes.
Is it used very often in Italian cooking?
Well, yes.
Is it in the garlic family?
Yes.
Is it indeed garlic?
Yes. Mr. Botley is a retired government employee who is found a new occupation. He grows garlic, and this is his second year, and he's having a great time. He grows garlic called elephant garlic. They're 8 times larger than the standard size garlic, which is a happy thought. Right? Elephant, right. Garlic, that's eight right. times that, and he's got a whole new life, and he's having a grand time.
I bet his neighbors have a whole new life, too.
We had so much fun with that. We'll throw all those cards over, and thank you very much, Mr. Buffy. Nice to have you with us. Tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message. And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the panel is always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? This time, a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin things with Bennett, sir.
Well, unless those lecherous, lascivious whistles have led me astray, this is a very pretty girl. Are you?
Yes, indeed. Miss Newman.
Are you in a movie that's currently in New York?
Well, perhaps I would hope so.
Mr. Ustinov?
But you don't live in New York.
No, not for my nose, no.
What?
No.
Yes, yes, does not live in New York. Miss Francis?
Are you something other than American?
Well, in my mind.
What? But not really. Mr. Cerf.
She is American. Are you quite a young star?
Well, But that is younger than 9 out of 16.
Younger than 30, let's say.
Yeah.
What, younger than 30 is
yes.
what I meant.
Miss Newman?
Is your hair dark?
Yes.
Mr. Ustinov?
Your hair is not light.
No.
Are you here on a visit?
Are you here for what?
And have you got your visa?
You mean to come to New York, Peter?
I answered? Oh, I haven't answered the question yet.
No, haven't. No.
Are you going back somewhere soon?
Well, are you going back somewhere soon?
Shortly, in probability, yes.
Miss Francis?
Did you recently visit Harvard University?
Well, you found me out.
Yes? Yes, you did?
Yeah.
Yes. Is it Natalie Wood?
Natalie Wood.
Quite a remarkable young lady, and also very lucky, you know, with that wonderful accent. You'd never know she was born in San Francisco, California. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Tofts is salaried and deals in a service. And I think we should begin things with Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Mr. Tofts, do you do your service in London? Do you perform your service in London?
Yes.
When you perform your service, do people watch you do this?
Yes.
When you do what you do, could it be called entertaining?
Yes.
Oh. Let me just interject something here. We agree that Mr. Tofts can perform his service in London. This does not exclude other localities. Two, we agree that people watch him, but this does not necessarily mean anything more than that there are other people present, and that since what he does would be interesting, they would watch.
Where did I go wrong?
You didn't. No, you didn't. I just didn't want you to be misled by too broad an answer, that's all.
I see. But you said that it is you would consider it entertaining.
Yes.
Yes. Now, do people pay to see you do what you do?
Yes.
When you do what you do, would I like what you did better if I were younger than what I am?
No,
I don't think so.
Right.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Tofts, are you left-handed?
Yes.
You noticed the training. You use both hands on your job?
Yes.
But you use your left hand rather than your right hand?
No.
Nope. That's 2 down at 8 to go, Miss Francis.
What were you driving at?
I wasn't driving at all. I was a passenger.
Are there any people doing what you're doing when you're doing it?
I don't understand that question.
Are there other people doing whatever you do when you are doing what you do? Rather than doing it solo.
I'm still baffled. I'm sorry.
Instead of doing what you do solo, are other people doing it at the same time?
No.
You're all alone.
You see, this is the trouble. This is why this gives us a little burden. The exact same thing, the answer would be no. But if the intent of your question was to ask if others were working in the same area and to achieve perhaps the same or a similar end, the answer would be yes.
That's what I meant.
That's what you had.
What I had in mind.
Then the answer is yes.
Is what you do something that might be considered some kind of game or sport?
No,
I don't think so. 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tufts, when you are performing this service, are you wearing something other than what you're wearing on this panel show this evening?
No.
4 down and 6 to go, Miss Newman.
When you do what you do, is there any music involved?
Yes.
When you do what you do, do you do the music? Do you have anything to do with the music?
5 down and 5 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
When you do what you do... I presume you are not conscious of the music.
Yes, I'm conscious of the music.
But what I mean by conscious is, do you have any link with the music?
Yes.
Do you have to keep in time?
Yes. Sorry, no matter how you rephrase it, the old no is coming right down the road. That's 6 down.
You've never learned English here. It was a perfectly good phrase.
What can I tell you, sir? What can I tell you?
Equivocal, like all good English phrases.
6 down and 4 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work, Mr. Tofts, in either a club or a hotel room or a theater?
I could work in any one of those places.
Is the audience ever used with you when you are performing? Are they part of what you do, the people that are watching you?
You mean in the sense of audience participation so that they would be critical and necessary to the completion of the service which he wants to deliver?
No is my answer, right?
That's right. 7 down and 3 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tofts, do you ever warble a song or play some instrument that renders that song?
No, sir. Nope. I'm pretty unmusical.
8 down and 2 to go, Miss Newman.
Now, we have to get back to this. You're doing what you're doing. Somewhere else, there's music playing. Or there, music is playing. Is that right so far?
Yes.
Are you speaking? Do you say anything?
No.
That's 9 down and 1 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
And you say you're dressed as you are now. Is that, did I understand that correctly?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
You are there regularly and not in an emergency.
Right.
There regularly.
Do people pay to see you?
Not to see me, no.
Not to see him, but with Mr. Toff's permission, we'll let the question go on the broader basis that people do pay to see what is the end result of the service.
You are not in sight from the audience point of view. You are behind the stage or arena.
That's right.
You work some kind of technical instrument or crew.
Yes.
John,
are you in charge of people or... just a moment. Maybe this will refresh your memory. Are you to do with the stage management side of anything?
No.
Not specifically, but you came very close, Peter, and you're to be congratulated, because 10 down and no more to go, Mr. Tofts makes Superman fly in the Broadway musical. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's Superman.
Very good.
I'm delighted to see that the British aircraft industry is not dead.
Yes, there's one plane they don't have to buy from America.
Yes.
Now, that'd be very interesting. Mr. Tofts climbs on a 14-foot ladder, and there's a torso harness around the flyer, I guess you'd call it. And it's counterweighted. And when it's time for him to take off, he just goes right down, jumps off the ladder, and down he goes, and then two other men work by the guys,
assistants.
And they handle this flight and or this flight pattern. So
it's the same way that Mary Martin does. In
That's right.
Pan.
It's similar to Mary
Do
Martin,
you work
but
with
we
her
slightly.
Too?
No, I've not worked with Mary Martin, but I did the old-fashioned Peter Pan in England as a penance, which we call penance time in England, flying Peter Pan in England. With
well, it's different Lockwood. Because Mary Martin and he have different corridors. There have been so many collisions lately.
Well, Mr. Thompson, these are the second panel, and thanks for coming to see us. Well, nice to see you. We'll have another contestant for you in just a moment after this word. And now to meet our next challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Frank M. Botley, right, sir?
Mr. Botley, where are you from, sir?
Hazel, Pennsylvania.
Hazel?
Hazleton,
Pennsylvania.
Yes, sir.
Well, you have some friends in the house. Nice to have you with us. May I present the panel? And now, Mr. Botley, if you'll join me over here, sir, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. As I told you, panel, a nice, relaxed, easygoing evening we're going to have tonight. We can tell you that Mr. Botley is self-employed and deals in a product. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Botley, is it a useful product?
Yes.
Is it a product that I might possibly own?
Yes.
Might a man own it, too?
Man? Yes.
If either one of us had this product, might we keep it in the house?
Yes.
Would it be in any... if we had a two-story house, would it be on the lower floor?
Yes.
Would I be able to hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Would I want to?
Want to? Yes.
Would I ever have it in the kitchen?
Yes.
Is it consumable?
Yes.
Would I put it in my mouth?
Yes.
Would it be all right if I swallowed it?
Yes.
Is it something other than something I might keep in the refrigerator?
Yes.
Is it something other than food?
Well, it's food.
Is it something it I would not have in my diet? Does that make it easier? No.
Well, you wouldn't specifically... yes, you would not specifically have it in your diet. It is consumed. It is certainly a
yes.
food. It is related to the whole process of eating and so forth.
Would I be liable to put it on something rather than have it all by itself?
Well, you could put it on something.
Would it make me happy?
Oh, yes.
Yes?
Yeah?
Is it liquid rather than solid?
No.
Something solid could make me happy, too.
Yeah, what? That's $1.09 to go, Bennett.
Mr. Botley, I know that Hazleton's sort of a center of the... coal industry. May I eliminate any product, whatever, that has to do with the coal industry?
Yes.
I ate it.
Well, coal can be made into all kinds of candy and stuff. Yeah? Cold drinks? You've heard of cold drinks, haven't you? Mr. Botley, this is definitely something to eat. You're not taking us down the garden path.
We have said that it's a part of the food family, yes.
Might it be considered a spice or condiment?
Yes.
Has it got a sharp, tangy taste?
Yes.
Would it ever be used with frankfurters?
Could be.
Is it brownish in color?
No.
It's not mustard.
It's 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Newman.
Mr. Botley, if I left this out in the kitchen, would it smell?
Well.
Yeah, you know it was around. Yeah, under certain circumstances.
Okay, now, it has a sharper odor than most normal foods have. A stronger odor?
Mm-hmm,
yes.
If I had a knife, could I cut it?
Yes.
Is it in any way a dairy product?
No. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Bartley, I don't want to seem greedy, but is there room for 2 at once of these things in my mouth?
Yeah, there'd be room.
Well, then I presume that there's room for many more. A few more.
Few more?
They are usually consumed in the plural, are they?
Would one hardly taste? No, they're not usually consumed in the plural. 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Francis.
Does whatever this is grow?
To you by Polygrip, the modern cream denture adhesive that grips evenly, grips comfortably, grips firmly all day long. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, who just flew in from London just in time to be with us tonight. And here she is, Miss Phyllis Newman.
It's my great pleasure tonight to introduce a very talented man who just finished writing, directing, and appearing in a movie which will open in the middle of May in New York, Lady L, Mr. Peter Ustinov.
And now, dressed in a ravishing pink tennis net, the foot faultless Arlene Francis.
And now an extraordinary gentleman who runs the gamut from punster to publisher and does both exceedingly well, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I've always told you what a fraud our panel moderator is. I read in the paper this morning, picking up the paper idly, a recipe, John Daly's recipe for how to make swordfish. Now, he's never been nearer a kitchen than when he called out to his wife for a piece of sweetbot. And here he is giving recipes for how to make swordfish. And here is the swordfish expert himself, John Charles Daly.
What Bennett neglected to say was I never made any claims to being able to cook. I just said, know what I'd like to eat. And swordfish I like to eat very much. Besides, speaking of frauds, I'm glad you're going back. Bennett's going back to school this week, and nobody needs it more than he does. He's going to Fredonia to New York State University. And then you're going to Manhattan, Kansas, to Kansas State and Washburn University.
That's right.
And then you're going to run for Houston and Pittsburgh.
That's right.
Good gentleman. Doesn't get enough activity. Miss Newman and Mr. Ustinov, how nice to see you here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Did we do the right thing?
I think so.
You nervous?
No.
No, nothing to be nervous about. We've got some very interesting occupations, but I'm sure they'll give none of you any difficulty. So just relax and enjoy yourselves for the next half hour. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. But right now, let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
Peter Tofts. Right, sir? All right. Mr. Tofts, where are you from?
I come from London, England.
From London, England?
That's right.
Oh, it's nice to have you here. May I present our panel, Mr. Tofts?
Good evening.
And now, if you'll join me over here, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is.
Would I be able to hold it in my hand?
Yes.
Would I want to?
Want to? Yes.
Would I ever have it in the kitchen?
Yes.
Is it consumable?
Yes.
Would I put it in my mouth?
Yes.
Would it be all right if I swallowed it?
Yes.
Is it something other than something I might keep in the refrigerator?
Yes.
Is it something other than food?
Well, it's food.
Is it something it is. I would not have in my diet? Does that make it easier? No.
Well, you wouldn't specifically... Yes, you would not specifically have it in your diet. It is consumed. It is certainly a
yes.
food. It is related to the whole process of eating and so forth.
Would I be liable to put it on something rather than have it all by itself?
Well, you could put it on something.
Would it make me happy?
Oh, yes.
Is it liquid rather than solid?
No.
Something solid could make me happy, too.
Yeah, what? That's 1,009 to go, Bennett.
Mr. Bartley, I know that Hazleton's sort of a center of the coal industry. May I eliminate any product whatever that has to do with the coal industry?
Yes.
I ate it.
Well, coal can be made into all kinds of candy and stuff. Yeah? Cold drinks? You've heard of cold drinks, haven't you? Mr. Bartley, this is definitely something to eat. You're not taking us down the garden path.
We have said that it's a part of the food family, yes.
Might it be considered a spice or condiment?
Yes.
Has it got a sharp, tangy taste?
Yes.
Would it ever be used with frankfurters?
Could be.
Could be, eh? Is it brownish in color?
No.
No,
it's not
I don't...
mustard, I
no.
would say.
No, it's 2-8 to go, Miss Newman.
Mr. Botley, if... sir, if I left this out in the kitchen, would it smell?
Well...
You know it was around. Yeah, under certain circumstances.
Okay, now, it has a sharper odor than most normal foods have. A stronger odor?
Mm-hmm,
yes.
If I had a knife, could I cut it?
Yes.
Is it in any way a dairy product?
No. That's 3-7 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Bartley, I don't want to seem greedy, but is there room for 2 at once of these things in my mouth?
Yeah, that'd be wrong. That'd be wrong.
Well, then I presume that there's room for many more. Or not many more. I mean, a few more.
Few more?
They are usually consumed in the plural, are they?
No, they're not usually consumed in the plural. 4-6 to go, Miss Francis.
Does whatever this is grow in the ground?
Yes.
Is it used very often in Italian cooking?
Well, yes.
Is it in the garlic family?
Yes.
Is it indeed garlic?
Yes. Mr. Bartley, we should begin things with Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Mr. Tofts, do you do your service in London? Do you perform your service in London?
Yes.
When you perform your service, do people watch you do this?
Yes.
When you do what you do, could it be called entertaining?
Yes.
Oh. Let me just interject something here. We agree that Mr. Tofts can perform his service in London. This does not exclude other localities. Two, we agree that people watch him. But this does not necessarily mean anything more than that there are other people present, and that since what he does would be interesting, they would watch.
Where did I go wrong?
You didn't. No, you didn't. I just didn't want you to be misled by too broad an answer, that's all.
I see. But you said that it is, you would consider it entertaining.
Yes.
Yes. Now, do people pay to see you do what you do?
Yes.
When you do what you do, would I like what you did better if I were younger than what I am?
No, I don't think so.
Right. One down and nine to go, Mr. Ustinov.
Mr. Tofts, are you left-handed?
Yes.
You noticed the training. Is You use both hands on your job?
Yes.
But you use your left hand rather than your right hand?
No.
Nope. That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
What were you driving at?
I wasn't driving at all. I was a passenger.
Are there any people doing what you're doing when you're doing it?
I don't understand that question.
Are there other people doing whatever you do when you are doing what you do? Rather than doing it solo.
I'm still baffled. I'm terribly sorry.
Instead of doing what you do solo, are other people doing it at the same time?
No.
You're all alone.
No, you see, this is the trouble. This is why this gives us a little burden. The exact same thing, the answer would be no. But if the intent of your question was to ask if others were working in the same area and to achieve perhaps the same or a similar end, the answer would be yes.
That's what I meant.
That's what you had.
It's really what I had in mind.
Then the answer is yes.
Is what you do something that might be considered some kind of game or sport?
No,
I don't think so. Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tufts, when you are performing this service, are you wearing something other than what you're wearing on this panel show this evening?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Newman.
When you do what you do, is there any music involved?
Yes.
When you do what you do, do you do the music? Do you have anything to do with the music?
Five down and five to go, Mr. Ustinov.
When you do what you do... I presume you are not conscious of the music.
Yes, I'm conscious of the music.
But I mean, what I mean by conscious is, do you have any link with the music?
Yes.
Do you have to keep in time?
Yes. Sorry, no matter how you rephrase it, the old no is coming right down the road. That's six down.
You've never learned English here. It is a perfectly good phrase.
I tell you, sir. What can I tell you?
Equivocal, like all good English phrases.
Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work, Mr. Tofts, in either a club or a hotel room or a theater?
I could work in any one of those places.
Is the audience ever used with you when you are performing? Are they part of what you do, the people that are watching you?
You mean in the sense of audience participation so that they would be critical and necessary to the completion of the service which he wants to deliver?
No is my answer, right?
That's right. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Tofts, do you ever warble a song or play some instrument that renders that song?
No, sir. Nope. I'm pretty unmusical.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Newman.
Now, we have to get back to this. You're doing what you're doing. Somewhere else, there's music playing. Or there, music is playing. Is that right so far?
Yes.
Are you speaking...
The retired government employee who has found a new occupation. He grows garlic, and this is his second year, and he's having a great time. He grows garlic called elephant garlic. They're eight times larger than the standard size garlic, which is a happy thought. right. Elephant, right. Garlic, that's eight right. times that, and he's got a whole new life, and he's having a grand time.
I bet his neighbors have a whole new life.
We had so much fun tonight. We'll throw all those cards over, and thank you very much, Mr. Buffy. Nice to have you with us. Tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message. And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the panel is always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? Panel, this time a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin things with Bennett, sir.
Well, unless those lecherous, lascivious whistles have led me astray, this is a very pretty girl. Are you?
Yes, indeed. Miss Newman.
Are you in a movie that's currently in New York?
Well, perhaps I would hope so.
Mr. Ustinov?
But you don't live in New York.
No, not for my nose, no.
What?
No. No. Yes, yes, does not live in New York. Miss Francis?
Are you something other than American?
Well, in my mind.
What? But not really. Mr. Cerf.
He is American. Are you quite a young star?
Well, But that is younger than 9 out of 16.
Younger than 30, let's say.
Yeah.
What, younger than 30 is
yes.
what I meant.
Miss Newman?
Is your hair dark?
Yes.
Mr. Ustinov?
Your hair is not light.
No, no.
Are you here on a visit?
Are you here for what?
And have you got your visa?
You mean to come to New York, Peter?
Have yeah. I answered? Oh, I haven't answered the question yet.
No, haven't. No.
Are you going back somewhere soon?
Well, are you going back somewhere soon?
Shortly, in probability, yes.
Miss Francis?
Did you recently visit Harvard University?
Well, you found me out.
Yes? Yes, you did?
Yeah.
Is it Natalie Wood?
Natalie Wood.
Quite a remarkable young lady, and also very lucky, you know, with that wonderful accent. You'd never know she was born in San Francisco. California girl.
She's the best sport in Hollywood.
And the best sport in Hollywood.
She came to the Harvard boys who were kidding her, and she appeared there and won the hearts of the entire Harvard University.
Oh.
Yeah. Actually, Bennett can speak with validity here. He's still trying to get through. What? No, but you are a San Franciscan.
Yes, I was born in San Francisco.
Uh-huh. And I love that country
California.
Up there. This year I found a desert this week, the Borrego Springs. Have you ever been down there? It's
no.
quiet and peaceful, beautiful,
no.
beautiful.
Is it near Santa Rosa?
No, actually it's north.
To you by Polygrip, the modern cream denture adhesive that grips evenly, grips comfortably, grips firmly all day long. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York. Let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, who just flew in from London just in time to be with us tonight. And here she is, Miss Phyllis Newman.
It's my great pleasure tonight to introduce a very talented man who just finished writing, directing, and appearing in a movie which will open in the middle of May in New York, Lady L, Mr. Peter Ustinov.
And now, dressed in a ravishing pink tennis net, the foot-faultless Arlene Francis.
Thank you, Peter. And now an extraordinary gentleman who runs the gamut from punster to publisher and does both exceedingly well, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I always told you what a fraud our panel moderator is. I read in the paper this morning, picking up the paper idly, a recipe, John Daly's recipe for how to make swordfish. Now, he's never been nearer a kitchen than when he called out to his wife for a piece of sweet box. And here he is giving recipes for how to make swordfish. And here is the swordfish expert himself, John Charles Daly.
What Bennett neglected to say was I never made any claims to being able to cook. I just said, know what I'd like to eat. Swordfish I like to eat very much. Besides, speaking of frauds, I'm glad you're going back. Bennett's going back to school this week, and nobody needs it more than he does. He's going to Fredonia to New York State University. Then you're going to Manhattan, Kansas, to Kansas State and Washburn University.
That's right.
And then you're going to run for Houston and Pittsburgh.
That's right.
A gentleman doesn't get enough activity. Miss Newman and Mr. Ustinov, how nice to see you here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Did we do the right thing?
I think so.
You nervous?
No.
No, nothing to be nervous about. We've got some very interesting occupations, but I'm sure they'll give none of you any difficulty. So just relax and enjoy yourselves for the next half hour. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program, but right now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please?
Peter Tofts.
Right, sir? All right. Mr. Tofts, where are you from?
I come from London, England.
From London, England?
That's right.
Oh, it's nice to have you here. May I present our panel, Mr. Tofts?
Good evening.
And now, if you'll join me over here, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Tofts is salaried and deals in a service. And I think...
King, do you say anything?
No.
No. That's 9-1 to go, Mr. Ustinov.
And you say you're dressed as you are now. Is that... Did I understand that correctly?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm.
Oh. You are there regularly and not in an emergency.
Right.
There regularly.
Do people pay to see you?
Not to see me, no.
Not to see him, but with Mr. Tofts' permission, we'll let the question go on the broader basis that people do pay to see what is the end result of the service. That
you are not in sight from the audience point of view. You are behind the stage or arena.
That's right.
You work some kind of technical instrument or crew.
Yes.
John,
are you in charge of people or... just a moment. Maybe this will refresh your memory. Are you to do with the stage management side of anything?
No.
Not specifically, but you came very close, Peter, and you're to be congratulated because 10-1 and no more to go. Mr. Tofts makes Superman fly in the Broadway musical. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's Superman.
Very good.
I'm delighted to see that the British aircraft industry is not dead.
Yes, there's one plane they don't have to buy from America. Yes. Now, that'd be very interesting. Mr. Tofts climbs on a 14-foot ladder, and there's a torso harness around the flyer, I guess you'd call it. And it's counterweighted. And when it's time for him to take off, he just goes right down, jumps off the ladder, and down he goes. And then two other men work by, I guess you call the guys, and they handle this flight and or this flight pattern. So
it's the same way that Mary Martin does.
That's right. It's similar to Mary Martin.
You work
but
with her
slightly
too?
No, I've not worked with Mary Martin, but I did the old-fashioned Peter Pan in England as a penance, which we call penance time in England, flying Peter Pan in England.
With well, it's different upward. Because Mary Martin and he have different corridors. There have been so many collisions lately.
Well, Mr. Thompson, at least we stuck the panel, and thanks for coming to see us. Bye-bye. Nice to see you. We'll have another contestant for you in just a moment after this word. And now to meet our next challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? Frank M. Botley, right, sir?
Botley, where are you from, sir?
Hazleton, Pennsylvania.
Hazleton, Pennsylvania.
Yes, sir.
Well, you have some friends in the house. Nice to have you with us. May I present the panel? And now, Mr. Botley, if you'll join me over here, sir, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. As I told you, panel, a nice, relaxed, easygoing evening we're going to have tonight. We can tell you that Mr. Botley is self-employed and deals in a product. And let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Botley, is it a useful product?
Yes.
Is it a product that I might possibly own?
Yes.
Might a man own it, too?
Ma'am? Yes.
If either one of us had this product, might we keep it in the house?
Yes.
Would it be in any, would it, if we had a two-story house, would it be on the lower floor?